when you have a character who's existed in the series from chapter one, like Jack is seen in the very first chapter coming back with Julius, and yet this is chapter 278 and we finally get some backstory for him. And it's not like this is some new surprise for like Jack, because the other, like, I think all the other captains, for the most part, we have had some aspects of their character to them. Like, even, like, Goldry, like, we found out about, like, his dark dealings and whatnot, some of his criminal underworld stuff, way early on. And then, like, Kaiser, we even knew Kaiser was a previous captain who retired. We know that he's married and stuff. Like, there's a smaller aspects to it, but Jack, I don't think we, up until this point, really had anything, like, about his character shown, or relatively anything about his backstory, where he came from. I think a lot of people assumed that he would have some form of murderer background, just because, you know, his name is Jack the Ripper, and, you know, that was a real person. And usually, when people do references to the character Jack the Ripper, it tends to always involve that. But maybe, you know, Jack the Ripper in this one is just like he's Jack and then got the title the Ripper for how his magic is, which makes sense. But at the same time, like, I'm surprised that didn't have anything to do with, like, his style. I mean, like, I assumed, like, a criminal that was, you know, really dangerous, and then they had to find a way to utilize him the best they can, because we know that the Clover Kingdom is willing to do that, because William otherwise should still be locked up. Like, if not executed, locked up. But Julius did him a solid. But all on top of it, we know that Julius knew that they were going to need William for defending for the Clover Kingdom, just in general. And then we didn't even really know anything about Jack's magic until, like, a good chunk in the way of the Elf Resurrection arc. And that was, I want to say, like, 160, 170 chapters in or so. Because we only knew he had the severing magic. But up until that point, it was just like, okay, he had, like, different kinds of ways to slash people. That's not that special. Now we know that, okay, well, the better ability of it is the fact that he can continuously adapt to other people's magic. Very good. So, when we were going to this chapter, because I think everyone knew, like, that what was going to happen, the format of this chapter, after the last three chapters, like, we're getting Clover characters spotlight, they're showing off new abilities and whatnot, and I think that's important, because there's no way that the Spain people are down. Like, we're just getting started. Like, the main cast is only one person so far. Like Yuno's the only one here. Noelle's not here yet. Asta's not here yet. They haven't even opened up the first gate of the Quilthoth. Like, things are still getting started. And Jack just getting, like, a moment against Dante was really nice. I was very happy about that. And also, just on a side note, I did think it was really funny, just the last few days of people talking about Nox's form, because it was one of the first things that was, like, leaked amongst the chapter to the fans. And the original, like, leaks, where it's, like, super low quality, it looked awful. It literally looked like he was just a big Lego man, like just a brick. And then we got the fan translation. I really wanted to know exactly what it did and whatnot, just because this chapter had two new things. Like, we got knocked another form. We know he's got two more. And we got Jack's upgrade. And I was like, okay, I'm just going to read it. I mean, generally, I look, but I don't do my chapter reviews until the officials come out, because, you know, I still got to report the official release and whatnot. And I do have the account for Viz, so it's like, I'm already paying for it, so I might as well wait a bit. But it looks so much better in the officials, and I think everyone assumed that, because you can tell what he's wearing. It's like the weird, like, square design on his, like, poncho. It looks very odd, just the pattern on it. But the way that it looked in the unofficials, it looked like he had, like, a weird TV chest. It was very strange. But I definitely like it a lot more when we can see it. I definitely the dog one is way better. This one was giving me some Pain Packer vibes, just the way that it kind of looked, like the mask and how bulky it was. But it's just like he says toughness, essentially. But, like, I kind of like the fortitude that was stated in the unofficials. But either way, it looks as just a big, sturdy tank. And it gives him a physical strength upgrade, because he was able to push back Dante when Dante was coming in. But
Dante at the start of the chapter, we know that he has, like, he got upgraded for Morris, and, like, we see a little bit of a demonstration here. Like, the plain Death Scythe, like, Lunatic Slash abilities, without having adapted yet, just starts cutting into him. And before the blades even exit the other side of his body, he's already healed. Like, it's not like he gets chopped up and then, kind of just puts himself back together or something. And it's like, he's just fast healing. Way too quickly for Jack to do anything. And we know how Dante is. Dante doesn't take people very seriously if he doesn't think that there's, like... If there's no emotional investment in there is really, I think, the best way to kind of put it. Because he starts out this chapter very similar to how he was when he invaded the Black Bull's base. Like, he's got that kind of non-caring expression, but at the same time, it's a little smug. Like, he's got that slight smirk to him. And because he knows that he's got such a powerful magic combination with gravity and body magic, and then his level of regeneration, it's like most of these people aren't going to do anything to him. So he likes to just kind of, like, talk down to him. And it makes sense. And these last couple chapters, there's been a lot of shit talking, and I've liked that a lot, just because the character interactions in general, I think, have been really fun. I've really enjoyed just seeing them converse. And, you know, it tells us a lot about all these guys. And we already know stuff like Nocte and Jack, and we knew that they were going to be, you know, slandering and throwing shade around, not just the Dante, but to each other. And that was what was used in this chapter, because... Like, right when he uses Presence of the Demon King, like, Nocte's able to, like, use his union. I'm trying to remember if this, I think it is a donkey. Somebody mentioned that. I thought it was, like, a bull this whole time for his devil. Because I know it was, like, there's the chicken, but I think it's a rooster, the cat, the dog. I thought it was a bull, but somebody said donkey, and I saw a picture that, like, they're based off of, and I'm pretty sure it is supposed to be a donkey. So, small correction, just I thought that was kind of funny. I was like, oh, but... Sometimes you just run into, like, very easy to misunderstand things that stick in your brain. But I was going to go off on a small story, but I don't want to right now. I'll save it for a stream. If anyone remembers this story that I kind of hinted at, just bring up. It has to do with My Hero, but I don't want to go into that because it's a Black Clover video. But if somebody brings it up to, like, a stream or something, I'll definitely tell it. Because it was funny, and I was just like, oh, shit. But, you have Jack on the ground. Jack is pushed down. Nocte is just, like, slandering him, telling him, like, oh, you know, I thought you'd be more, but I guess not. No, at least Yami was something. And obviously, Jack, that's going to piss him off, because that's his rival. Even if they don't have that same kind of presence, like, when they talk to each other, as, like, Asta, Zell and Fuego and stuff, these two are definitely, like, their rivals, but they're way more... They're way more of, like, Zoro and Sanji kind of rivals, where they don't really like each other, except for, I would imagine, the base premise of they're still overall on the same team. It's not like Natsu and Gray, whereas they fight a lot, but they still actually like each other. You know, they still have, like, a very family vibe to it. There's this more like two brothers fighting, whereas... Jack and Yami, similar to Sanji and Zoro, are like two co-workers. They don't like each other, but at the end of the day, they're on the same team. So, and then they definitely have, you know, have competition for each other. So talking down to Jack, as well as reminding him, like, stuff about, like, Yami, and then putting that over him is definitely going to piss him off. And Dante in the chapter, It's a really good example of why people need to remember that, like, Dante isn't that serious. Like, Dante could put up, like, he could get some of his body magic, he can use some of his gravity magic, put on the devil power, but it doesn't really matter if he's not in that mood to actually fight. Because we know he needs to be motivated in order to actually get anywhere. He's too playful otherwise. Like, Zenon is just going for the kill. Like, we don't know the full extent of, like, what his personality is really like. Vonica just does not care if she doesn't think there's a good fight between them. But we know when she's excited, she gets immediately tries to get, like, psychotic in her battles. Whereas, like, Dante, when you look at, like, the start of the chapter and then the part where Nocte presses it, like, just punches him and, like, pushes him back, he gets excited. He likes it when he ends up having some new emotion, or he sees people experiencing these darker emotions. Like, he's happy to see Nocte have that malice. Like, he's like, oh, sweet, yeah, you keep going. I like seeing it. You know, just good vibes in here. Just put that hatred and like vicious quality of your personality, you know, right in your chest, and let's fight. Like, he's an odd dude in that. People need to remember that. Like, after even Jack getting this new power, this is where Dante gets serious. Because at the very end, you see that slash that Jack puts in against Dante. He cuts his horn, knocks his crown off. You see the difference in color of the slash, too. So I'm guessing that he's actually doing damage to his devil powers. Because if he cuts the horn, and then I'm guessing the color difference, it's like he's cutting into his devil power. And then that kind of like, oh shit face that Dante has. Because the difference between Dante and the other villains, like, really, you got to look at what he's like. When you have one of those oh shit moments from other villains, you're like, oh crap, they're gonna have to do some serious, they're gonna have to like figure out what they're doing, they don't want to get pressed like this. We know that that expression is when Dante actually starts to get excited in fights. That's when he actually starts to put in effort and starts taking his opponent more seriously. And we even like have him get ready to use a singularity against Jack. And when Jack slashes him at the end of the chapter, you don't see his hand at all. So you don't know if he cut the singularity. So he might just throw it at him next scene. And there's no way that Dante's going to lose here. I mean, come on. But I did really like the way that Jack advanced his abilities. Because the thing about Jack versus all the other characters, like with Charlotte, we saw that she, you know, had worked her cursed version of her Briars in a way to develop a new skill. With Yuno, he's stockpiling the mana to kind of achieve like a much more powerful form. Mariliona's gotten like a new form as well. Theirs is all like in new additional abilities and the ways that it's dispensed, whereas Jax is more of upgrading his baseline ability, because Jack doesn't need some extra power. Like, Jack doesn't need, kind of like when Yami got Dimension Slash, before that Yami just had all these dark magic attacks, like he had like this black hole for like CC and stuff, but for the most part he didn't have any super dangerous powers. He was good and he was strong and he had like very good combinational skills with his magic, but there was nothing about it that had that, you know, that kind of full like follow through ace in the hole, like something like Dimension Slash was like his big trump card move. Jack, though, the way that his magic works, similar to like Mariliona, where Mariliona can burn magic, and like Mariliona's upgraded version is just like she's covering herself with her fire-burning magic, and as well as like she's able to just dispense way more as she's doing it. Jack, I didn't think was good, like needed to have a new power added on to his severing magic and the way that his blades adapt. I figured it was going to be like a different blade shape, though, or a different way that it's implemented. Like if you read Kimetsu no Yaiba, you know, Demon Slayer, and you know about Kokoshibo, his, I'm trying to remember exactly, what, Breath of the Moon? I can't remember exactly what his technique is called. But the way that his attacks go and the way that they kind of just move around the battlefield, I thought we could, you know, you could do something like that. Or maybe Jack has multiple blades, or like a big blade with multiple blades on it, so it's like each slash does 5 or something instead of 1. Just a different way that it's dispensed after he uses it. Because again, he doesn't need an extra power. Like, Jack's power is, it's something like Mariliona's or Julius's, or it's just universally good at a fundamental level. And what he did here, covering himself with his blades and then kind of just freely controlling them and having them slash around him, what he's doing is he has them adapt to the gravity magic. Because the gravity magic, at the end of the day, is magic. It's not the same as, like, outright he's just, you know, it's just gravity. Like, he's cutting the concept of gravity. He's cutting the magic that is involved. We saw that when Asta first went berserk and that huge anti-magic pulse canceled out the gravity in the area. But what Jack is doing is his blades are adapting to the, you know, they're cutting and adapting to the magic around him and then slashing all of the gravity magic within the vicinity of him, so it's not affecting him. Just imagine what Yami did with Black Moon, but Jack is doing it in a much smaller bubble. Like, his is kind of just like, if you can just imagine like a tiny little sphere around him that extends to the tips of his blades. So within it, like, gravity magic is still going, but wherever Jack is, like, he's going to be just having essentially like a space where he's dissipating and cutting up the effects within that zone. And it would be like if, I guess really, just imagine Black Moon. Like, just imagine how it is when we saw Yami use Black Moon with his monozone. But again, it's just a little oval, you know, like a little bubble around Jack. And so this chapter, I thought was actually pretty good, just in general. None of these chapters have been big hype for me these last three, because I know it's how it's really going to set, it's setting everything up, rather. And I think, though, the value in these chapters have just been in displays. Because I imagine being a fan of Jack, and you have to wait this long in the story to get even a crumb of his backstory. And Jack's only got a couple spells. Like, he's got, like, his Death Scythe, and he's got his Lunatic Slash, and then General Reinforcement Magic. But he hasn't gotten much of an upgrade at all. And it wasn't like what Charlotte, like, we at least saw the Carla, the elf on her body, and we saw, like, all these different moves that she can achieve, where it's like, oh, this is something that if she just raises her level up, she'll be able to, you know, do herself. We didn't really see that with Jack. Like, even in the elf resurrection arc, we only really got Jack's magic, like, knowing what it did. We didn't get anything that new. We didn't get anything like a big character development moment for Jack. We got displays for Jack, which is still really fun, but we didn't get too much of them. It's kind of like the Captain's Battle. One of the things about the Captain's Battle, I think, was in the anime, you know, episode 151. I think the biggest value of that wasn't just like, oh, cool, a big fight. It was the fact that we were seeing multiple characters, like all these captains, and they're all getting some good spotlight. So, except Rill. Sorry, Rill fans. Rill fans definitely are in the longest wait right now. But the fact that you got to see all these characters all getting displays. It's not just Yami because of how popular Yami is, and it's not just someone like William or someone like Fuego or Nozel. It was all the captains, aside from Rill, that got to have like a big display. And I think that's more of the theme for these last couple chapters, is before like the big craziness kind of busts out, is getting to show these guys have some spotlight, giving these guys moments before, you know, shit hits the fan. Because here's the thing. Xenon hasn't gone past 55%. Monica was just getting up. And you see that, like, look on Dante's face. You know, the next chapter, like, the next time we see Dante, and he's going to have a speech bubble in his head about, you know, this, like, you know, the same thing when he was fighting Yami. He's like, oh, this, like, pathetic look I've got on my face getting pretz like this. Thank you. And he's going to get excited. He's going to get monstrous. And I fully believe he can go higher than 80%. Like, not only is he clearly the most powerful of the three, at least for currently, but I fully believe his body magic is going to be a key factor in being able to go higher than what he is. And, like, he just got upgraded from Morris, so it's not unbelievable. Like, if the explanation partially is like, oh, you know, X reasons, we already know that the fact that there are two different dimensions, like, he can't go 100%, but if there's anything like, oh, the human body can only take up to so much, doesn't matter. Dante is completely different because he can alter his body to compensate for it. So if it was like something where, oh yeah, after 80%, like, it can stop your heart or something, whatever the explanation is, Dante could just be like, okay, and then just continuously, fix his heart in a fight and then make it so he can go above 80%. It's very interesting in the idea of it, because it can happen so simplistically, and at the same time, it can have such dangerous effects for everybody around him. Like, very, very much. But anyway, other than that, though, like, the chapter was solid. I thought it was a really solid chapter. Like, it wasn't like a massive chapter. Like, the last time I think we got a huge chapter, when, you know, we saw Morris and, like, everyone prepping up to invade the Spade. But this has all been, up until that point, just the opening. Like, we haven't gotten to the serious parts yet. This is just the opening. This is what's getting the Triad actually in a mood to fight these guys, rather than just, you know, step on fodder to them. Because at the end of the day, they're all individually way more powerful than these captains, and it's just gonna take them to get serious before, like, stuff really turns around. But anyway, other than that, though, comment below, thumbs up the video, tell me what you think about this chapter. Like, if you're a Jack fan, like, are you satisfied with this new form for Jack, just covering these blades? I think it fits. And it doesn't just give Jack some crazy extra new ability. It advances what he already has. Kind of like what Mariliona had got with her form. And I like that a lot. Like,
Charlotte getting a new power, an aspect to hers was cool, but I like this more of a style for Jack, where his is just a upgraded form of what he's already got that's really good. Like, he didn't need a new ability added on to his severing magic. But anyway, other than that, comment below, thumbs up the video, from the like button, subscribe button, and check out my other videos. But other than that, I appreciate everyone who's already subscribed. Thank you all for listening. Bye.